welcome back. In this video, we're gonna see the share market basis. So in this video, we will be covering about what is the major difference between basic EPS versus diluted EPS. So guys, before going this video, if you are new to this channel, then make sure you click the subscribe button below, because you could get our latest updates each and every day, guys. And the first thing we are gonna see is about basic EPS. And what is about basic EPS? And this company we use is our own channel, Always About Indian Shares channel, that is been issued shares to people. So the number of shares we have issued, this is for imaginary purpose and not for real purpose, guys. And this is, so what is basically earning per share? EPS means earning per share, which means per share how much the company earns. So that is the meaning of this. So as per the namesake, basic EPS, basic means without any additions, the original effect. This profit is the net profit that is available to the public shareholders. So what is the effect that has been made to this profit? Suppose if the company has preference shareholders, for example, they want to pay 5 lakhs as a dividend. After paying the dividend, which amount is remaining? That amount is profit earned after all effects. It is 10 lakh rupees for our company. So 10 lakh rupees, guys, so 10 lakh rupees divided by 1 lakh share. 10 lakh rupees divided by 1 lakh shares, it is a EPS, which means earning divided by number of shares, E by S, which gives around rupees 10 as the EPS. So it is the basic EPS formula. I repeat again, guys, EPS is the earning per share. So EPS says that how much a company earns per share. So what is the usefulness of EPS, if you ask me, guys? The usefulness of EPS is that one person may know how much the company has shown growth per share. So it helps the company, or it helps the shareholder, in order to determine how much dividend can the company pay. Yes, guys, EPS is really useful in determining how much dividend can the company pay to a single shareholder, and it's very, very useful for the shareholder. So guys, as you can see, the title you have said that share market basis, and second is that diluted EPS. So the second thing we are going to see is that diluted EPS. So guys, listen this carefully, because basic EPS everyone can understand, but diluted EPS requires a special tinge of advice, so that if you listen it carefully, you could able to gain a lot of knowledge, guys. And same here, number of shares is 1 lakh shares, profit earned after is 10 lakh shares. So the two things are same. Shares going to be converted into future is 10,000 shares. Mean this future means it's selling in future, these shares are going to be converted. Okay, what are the shares? So why is diluted EPS very, very important, if you ask me, guys? Diluted EPS is very, very important because, for example, let us have a per se, if a company has debentures, or the employees have stock options which can be converted, convertible debentures into shares, employee options into shares, which are convertible in future. But in order to give the future effect in the current time, diluted EPS is being used. So what is the usefulness of diluted EPS? So if we say what is the usefulness of diluted EPS, it says the people, after this effect, after the conversion effort, how much will the shareholder gain? Whether it would decrease the earning per share, or whether it would increase the earning per share. In this example, we can see whether there can be an improvement, or there can be a deterioration of EPS. So basic EPS, as we computed, it comes around 10 rupees. As we computed here, guys, it is around 10 rupees per basic EPS. So let us have in this side, guys. So basic EPS, I'm writing here, you can see, right? Basic EPS is rupees 10. So what is basically diluted EPS, I tell? So in order to give a future effect, we are doing now itself. So here we are having already 1 lakh shares. So let us see, let us first, I can say this, these are debentures which are going to convert into future into 10,000 shares. So 1 lakh shares plus 10,000 shares give you 110,000 shares. So basic EPS formula are computed, guys. The EPS formula is earnings by number of shares. So 10 lakh shares you divide by 110,000, you get gives you around rupees 9.09. Yes guys, that means there is a deterioration in the EPS. Earlier when there were 1 lakh shares, the EPS was rupees 10. Now after this dilution, the EPS has come down to 9.09. So it is the dilution effect of EPS. And I hope I have made this content crisp so that you could be able to understand in a short language, guys. It is a spoon feeding to you so that you could be able to understand. So if you have any other doubts regarding any other basics in stock market, leave in comment section below. We would definitely make a presentation regarding it, guys. And this is our view on stock market basis, basic EPS versus diluted EPS. If you like this video, then make sure you click the subscribe button and also share this video to your friends who are beginners in stock market so that they could get a view about this content also. Thank you so much, guys. See another video very soon.